Hey guys, in this video, we are going to talk about Shopify dropshipping, what it is, and how beginners can earn $100 to $700 per day. More with that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasey here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. So Shopify dropshipping is one of those things that could potentially change your life like it did mine. Like with my story, if you've been following this for a while, you'll know that I went from $0 to $5,000 my first month to then $1.5 million my first year in revenue, and it was completely insane. But that was back in 2015 and 2016. So when most people talk about Shopify dropshipping right now, the first thing they ask is, well, number one, what is it? What are the pros and cons? And how can I get started? And even if it's actually gonna be a good opportunity or not. That's what we're gonna talk about in this video, if this still is gonna be a big opportunity for you to get started and what you can do to actually make the most of this new thing. So first we gotta break down what Shopify dropshipping is, and that's just breaking down into two things. Number one, Shopify. What is Shopify? Shopify is a really popular e-commerce store where literally within like 5 minutes, you could go ahead and create an e-commerce store. Now think about this, right? Shopify is like $29 a month or so, and it's extremely affordable compared to like the olden days when you would go and create your own website and e-commerce store. It was just extremely complicated. Like back in like 2005, my dad tried creating an e-commerce store, and it was like thousands of dollars to go and set up, and it was just completely confusing, and it was just overwhelming. We lost a bunch of money, and we didn't actually push through with that because my dad didn't really know the tech stuff, okay? Shopify is really amazing because you don't need to be a tech genius or have any tech skills to have a beautiful website. Literally within a second, you could get a beautiful e-commerce website like this. And when we talk about the dropshipping way, you can literally plug in products that you could already sell by the time you are done with this video. Now that we understand what Shopify is, let's talk about what the dropshipping business model is. Now they're kind of like used synonymously together because of the fact that they're very related with each other. So all it is your store is your Shopify website, okay? And on your store, you put a bunch of pictures and whatnot of products that you don't even own, okay? A really popular way to actually go ahead and get the products is AliExpress is where a lot of people come in and start dropshipping. And one of the first products that was really successful for me back in the day were grill mats, right? So what I did is I ended up buying some of these for like very, very cheaply. It got sent to my place and we just took really nice pictures of it, right? I didn't buy like thousands of units of it. I just put, you know, like a couple of really nice pictures on like my own Shopify store. And then voila, I had a store. How much inventory I had? Literally hundreds of thousands. How much I spent for that inventory? Literally zero, because I don't have to spend money on it until someone actually buys it. So here's an example. On my Shopify store, I put the picture up and you know, now it looks really pretty. I put it up for, I don't know, like 20 bucks or so, right? A customer comes in to my store and buys it for 20 bucks. I then literally take five of those dollars and I'll go to the supplier and give the customer's address to the supplier, in which the supplier will then ship the product to the customer. Just like that, I keep the profit, so I'm essentially the middleman when it comes to this. Now think about how beautiful that is. You don't have to deal with buying a bunch of inventory that no one might actually buy. You don't have to deal with having a high risk of capital, especially when it comes to testing, because you could literally test whatever product that you could actually go ahead and dropship. And these are actually so, so, so big, because one of the first business ideas that I tried doing back in the day was Amazon FBA, where I would literally buy thousands of products to just hope and pray that it would sell. And most of the times it wouldn't sell and I would be out of a lot of money, right? So Shopify dropshipping is a lot safer of a business model, especially if you're in like the testing phase of things. So the second question people then ask is, I was like, okay, Shopify dropshipping is amazing, Mike, but how can I actually go ahead and find a lucrative niche? Well, there's multiple different ways. Number one is just going and finding the best sellers on Amazon, okay? So one of my big products that was really successful on Shopify dropshipping was because my product on Amazon was just too much competition, right? And as you can see, if there's a lot of people competing on it and you see like hundreds, if not thousands of products on Shopify, what you probably know is because there's a lot, there's gonna be a lot of people that are making money from this, right? Now, when you look at Amazon, you see that there's so much competitors. There's so much. That's the reason why I had to get out, because there's just too many. But even though that's the case, The reason why there's a lot of competitors means that there's a lot of money to actually be made. So what I like doing, and this is like my lucrative niche, is you go ahead and create a niche for yourself based off of the pain points that, you know, existing customers of these Amazon people are talking about. So what I like doing is that I like going all the way down here and looking for what people don't like about it. It was talking about the grill mats melted, stuck the kitchen on the first use. We use this product and it was unsafe for food grilling. What these people are essentially doing is they're saying that they bought it because it's verified purchase, and they're telling you what they did not like about it. So when it comes to the dropshipping part of things, when you find a supplier, you wanna make sure that it kind of solves all of those problems, as well as in your marketing, you use all of these words that they didn't like about the old product so that you could kind of like have a unique advantage over all of these people. And how the supply chain essentially works is, you know, you put all these pictures on your Shopify store, you run advertising to it, or I'm gonna teach you a free way to actually do it later on when you stay until the end, which is like insane, and I can't believe not a lot of people are doing it yet because you can make so much money from it. But once people actually buy from it on this Shopify store, the next thing that you do, like I said, is just take the money and then you go to like AliExpress or eBay and go ahead and buy it directly from this person right here. You could see it's only a dollar, and yet on places like Amazon, they pay for $16 plus or $90 plus. This is the beauty of the dropshipping model. Look at this. You're getting it for dirt cheap and you're selling it for like $16 or $20 or $30 or whatnot. Now, the first level of things is you're just maybe buying one off from like AliExpress or eBay, right? But that leads us to the second way that you also gotta understand the entire supply chain, okay? In this entire business, there's three parties, and there's three people that have wants and needs. There's you and your customer. That's what most people actually think, that's the dropshipping business. But there's actually a third player that's just as important, and that's becoming friends with the supplier. Because the supplier can literally save your life in so much expenses and fees and whatnot. Like for example, I was dropshipping, not on AliExpress, but on eBay. I was going on eBay, let me pull this up right here. And I was just buying one-off orders from eBay and dropshipping them, right? Because I didn't want the Chinese supplier, I wanted a US supplier. Then one day, one of these eBay sellers reached out to me and they're like, dude, you're buying hundreds of products individually from eBay for me. Was that a mistake? I'm like, no, I'm dropshipping. Can I help you? It's like, oh, well, since you're dropshipping, what if you just kind of like downloaded all of your orders to me and sent it to me, and I could just ship it all myself and I'll just send you all the tracking information. And I'm like, are you serious? Because the thing about AliExpress and eBay is they take a percentage of the sale from these suppliers. And the suppliers don't like spending that money, right? They'd rather just save that money by paying you in terms of savings. Does that make sense? So becoming friends with these suppliers on, you know, AliExpress and eBay are huge. Which leads me to the fourth step, and that's finding the right supplier. Now, when it comes to dropshipping, you know, same way how the Americans and people in first world countries have like a huge opportunity, it's the exact same thing in China, but in terms of like suppliers, right? Which is why you wanna make sure that the products that you're selling are good. Like before I was like actively scaling like crazy and dropshipping like a madman, I would actually buy a product. Just one, it's only like a dollar or two, have it shipped to me and just see the actual product. Why is that? Number one, if I have a sample, I could take better pictures for my e-commerce store. Number two, if I know that it's good quality, then I know that the returns are gonna be lower. And number three, I know that the supplier is like legit, right? Because in China, there's a bunch of suppliers that are not legit because it's also a gold rush for them. So ensuring that the product is good and the communication between your supplier is one of the most important things. If you can maintain that communication, you can make a bunch of money, your supplier can make a bunch of money, and your customer can also get a product that they want. Now, the fifth way is the most interesting way, and that's how to actually scale and grow this company. Let's talk about this, cat supplies, right? This is actually really interesting because I wish I knew about this when I first got started, because how I got started was way too expensive, right? So as you can see, there's a lot of cat toys that you could go ahead and get started with for literally pennies on the dollar, right? You go ahead and create like a simple Shopify store like that. But then once you actually set it up, the next question is like, oh, that's great. How can I actually go ahead and sell this? Well, all you'd really need to do is find micro influencers that don't know that they're actual influencers yet, have them make a video about it, and create a promo code or a coupon code so that if someone buys through that link, the person that buys through the link, it's like, I don't know, 10 to 20%, but you get to credit the influencer with a percentage of the profits. Now think about this. It's no cost to you. It's essentially free. You're getting these people to make videos for you so you don't have to make videos yourself, and you can make money from that. So that's exactly how like Gymshark first got started, this company right here. They were just a dropshipping company that started paying their influencers through their promo codes. As you can see, the value of the company at $1 billion. And what they did in the beginning was they created these little promo codes so that if someone like went through your link, you know, like I said, the customer would get a discount, but they would know which one of these influencers were making them the most money, right? So as you can see in Cat Tips, what I like doing is scrolling down and finding these people that have hundreds and thousands of views with very little subscribers. Because odds are this Mia girl isn't making money from her YouTube channel. So if you literally go up to her and say, hey, we're a cat company that sells physical products and we would love to partner with you. Like, let us know what you think. And of course, she's like, oh my God, I could get paid to talk about cats. This is my dream, right? And what you do is you have her start making videos about what she normally likes talking about. But at the end of every video, you tell them to go to your Shopify store. Now, here's why it's huge. You have them put a promo code on there as well, right? So all of your e-commerce stores will be all on these links of all these like micro influencers. And then you get to track which one of these influencers are actually making you the most money, right? Like this Mia Stone person or this Deborah girl that has nearly a million views with only 16,000 subscribers. If you just do that alone, it's literally like free marketing. The only thing that you would need is maybe buy some of these products yourself and just send it to them, make it look nice and pretty so that these influencers could have like an unboxing experience, which of course is huge because that's exactly how a lot of big businesses and companies are now made. But guys, that's Shopify dropshipping in a nutshell. If you want a faster and easier way to make money online, make sure you sign up for the free workshop below. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you go and listen to all of my podcasts of all these multimillionaires that live here in Bali on the other side of the world that make money online and do whatnot. Check it out in the link below. And with that being said, I love you guys. I'll see you guys later. You.